Imagine a computer so powerful it could break every encryption on Earth in seconds. A machine that could simulate the entire universe, molecule by molecule. A device that operates by bending the very laws of physics as we know them. This isn't science fiction. This is the world of quantum computing, and it's happening right now. But before you lean back, thinking this is just another tech video, let me tell you something that will blow your mind. Quantum computers can literally exist in multiple states at once. Yes, you heard that right. While you're watching this video, you're either sitting or standing, right? Well, a quantum bit exists in both states simultaneously. And that's just the beginning of how weird things get. Back in 1981, the brilliant physicist Richard Feynman proposed something radical. What if we could build computers that operated according to quantum mechanics? At the time, it seemed impossible. But Feynman knew something crucial. Nature itself operates at the quantum level, so why shouldn't our computers? Your smartphone, powerful as it is, still processes information like a glorified abacus. It uses bits, simple ones, and zeros, on or off, yes or no. This binary system has served us well, but we're hitting a wall. Some problems are so complex that even our most powerful supercomputers would take longer than the age of the universe to solve them. Let me give you a concrete example. Imagine you're trying to factor a 300-digit number. Seems simple, right? Well, on a classical computer, this would take millions of years. Why does this matter? Because this exact problem is the foundation of most internet security. Our entire digital world relies on the fact that classical computers can't solve this quickly. In a quantum computer, we use quantum bits, or qubits. And this is where things get fascinating. A qubit doesn't have to choose between 1 or 0. Thanks to a phenomenon called superposition, it can be both at once. Think about that for a second. It's like having a coin that simultaneously heads and tails until you look at it. But it gets even stranger. Two qubits can be entangled, linked in such a way that affecting one instantly affects the other, no matter how far apart they are. Einstein called this spooky action at a distance. And it's so bizarre that even he couldn't accept it at first. Yet it's real, and we're harnessing it right now. When we add more qubits, their power doesn't just add up, it multiplies exponentially. Every additional qubit doubles the quantum computer's processing power. With just 300 qubits, you could represent more numbers simultaneously than there are atoms in the observable universe. That's not an exaggeration, that's the literal math. Why should you care? Because quantum computers are about to revolutionize everything we know. Let me show you how. In medicine, quantum computers could simulate molecular interactions with perfect accuracy. This means designing new drugs in days instead of years. Imagine finding the cure for cancer by simulating every possible molecular combination until we find the perfect match. In climate science, they could model the entire Earth's weather systems simultaneously. This means perfect weather prediction weeks in advance and a better understanding of climate change at a molecular level. In artificial intelligence, quantum computers could process complex patterns that classical computers can't even begin to approach. This could lead to AI systems that truly understand context and meaning, not just patterns. But perhaps the most immediate impact will be in the field of cryptography. Remember that 300-digit number I mentioned earlier? A quantum computer could factor it in seconds. This means every encryption system we currently use could become obsolete overnight. But don't panic just yet. Quantum computers also offer the solution: quantum encryption. This is encryption that uses the principles of quantum mechanics to create unbreakable codes, not hard to break, literally unbreakable by the laws of physics. Right now, companies like IBM, Google, and others are racing to build better quantum computers. One of Google's latest strides in this race is a new quantum chip known as Willow. This chip isn't just another incremental upgrade, it's a major step toward fault-tolerant quantum computing. Willow demonstrates improved qubit stability, reduced error rates, and architectural refinements that push beyond the proof of concept stage. If successful, it could help transition quantum computing from a fragile research endeavor into a reliable, scalable technology. In other words, Willow isn't just about achieving quantum supremacy, it's about making quantum computation practical, opening the door to breakthroughs in everything from secure communications to advanced materials and life-saving drugs. They're keeping these machines at temperatures colder than outer space. We're talking about a fraction of a degree above absolute zero. Why? Because quantum states are incredibly fragile. The slightest disturbance can cause them to decohere, lose their quantum properties. Building these machines isn't easy. These quantum computers face three major challenges. First, there's the temperature problem. We need to keep these computers colder than outer space, just a fraction of a degree above absolute zero. The cooling systems alone are engineering marvels. Second, there's the error problem. Quantum states can decohere at the slightest disturbance. Even a stray photon of light can ruin a calculation. It's like trying to build a house of cards in a hurricane while blindfolded. Third, there's the scaling problem. While we can build quantum computers with hundreds of qubits, we need thousands or even millions for many practical applications. And each additional qubit makes the system exponentially more complex to control. Right now, we're in the middle of a global race for quantum supremacy, the point where a quantum computer can solve a problem that no classical computer could solve in a reasonable time. Companies and nations are pouring billions into research, treating it like the space race of the 21st century. But here's what really keeps me up at night. Quantum computers might be the first machines to truly think differently than we do. Not artificially intelligent, quantum intelligent. They could solve problems in ways that human brains can't even comprehend. What happens when we have machines that can break any code? What does privacy mean in a quantum world? How will society change when we can simulate and predict complex systems with perfect accuracy? As we stand on the brink of this quantum revolution, one thing is clear: we're not just building faster computers, we're creating machines that operate on the fundamental fabric of reality itself. The question isn't whether quantum computers will change the world, it's whether we're ready for how much they'll change it. Remember, every time you think you understand quantum computing, you probably don't. And that's exactly what makes it so fascinating. The deeper we dig, the stranger and more beautiful the quantum world becomes. Until next time, keep questioning reality. And there you have it, the mind-bending world of quantum computing, where the impossible becomes possible. If your brain is still in superposition between amazed and confused, you're getting it right. Don't forget to hit subscribe and turn on notifications to explore more fascinating technologies that are shaping our future. Until next time, keep questioning reality.